And you said, my journey over the last year, I actually set out on the QNIS programme thinking that I was joining a programme to help me develop a leadership programme, a bespoke framework for continued professional development for the contemporary district nurse in possession of the new SPQ. I believe my project idea could deliver a programme of consolidation, mentorship and CPD. And in addition to this, I envisaged that the plan would be designed to harness innovation, foster excellent leadership and build on and expand new skills gained during that education programme. In Ayrshire Man, district nurses are studying at the University of West Scotland, and the SPQ district nurse qualification there attained there allows them to be registered as a district nurse in the NMC and work at an advanced practice level, but yet there's no framework exists to support them. And so therefore I thought I could have this neat and tidy idea that would develop something practical and present it to all our newly qualified district nurses. Simple, effective, job done. In addition to this, I felt the PNC Nurse Centre would enable you to raise the profile of community nursing within the hospital and across health and social care and ensure that the service is accessed appropriately. With the quiet workforce, you just get there and just do the job, and we never really get any credit for it. And I wanted to promote district nurses as having this pivotal role in the community, coordinating patient care and fundamental to shaping community services. And I also wanted nursing, district nurses, to be a dynamic career choice. And all these ideas. So off I went, over at me. Now all this queens sigh an absolute pleasure whenever we see that word out loud. It's becoming a refuge in a storm, a safe place, and we all feel transformed there. We actually loved it. It was where we all came together, we were cared for, nourished mentally, physically. I felt I'd be part of a cleverly constructed programme that addressed strengths and passions lying dormant within me, and I felt so stimulated. It was a truly therapy time. So when I went back to real life, I felt different. I was inspired, re-energising and bouncing with ideas. I couldn't believe it. I now knew that a box of chocolates and a mention in the local paper wasn't enough. Although my dad does still check the paper on a weekly basis. I thought it'd be really easy to have conversations back in the workplace that captured uniqueness, passion and aspirations, all the things that we heard about at the programme. I wanted to get across this feeling of valued individuals, embody at work the benefits and power of connection, compassion and kindness that I'd experienced there. I wanted to create a vibrant workplace where it felt natural to metaphorically hold each other, establishing a safe place where everyone had the courage to be vulnerable and be authentic. And I wanted conversations that shared joy and gratitude for the job that we did. And I wanted to celebrate who we all were, warts and all. And I wanted everyone to be present in the moment and to really, really feel what it was like to be them. Celebrate individual experiences and not be judged. I actually wanted everyone to see and identify with the new me. And I thought that would be amazing. However, they all thought it was completely bonkers. Then, here she goes, and eventually she would calm down. Things will soon be back to normal, but they told me, listen, we're really busy and not happy being asked to have an opinion on things and change this working environment, you know, just looking back to the day job. And I think that's because we're so used to just being done to. We're so used to things happening around us and we just keep plowing away, just doing the same job. And where I work, we're renowned in our area for being a really good district nursing team, a great team to work in. But I wanted us to be more than that. I wanted us to be a fabulous, innovative team. And at this point, met with all this resistance, I could easily have given up. And I questioned if I had the tenacity to do this and persevere in the face of all this reluctance. I couldn't, because I felt differently. And I knew if I could inject a tiny bit of what I had felt, then the world would have persevered, and the cracks showed. I stuck my foot in the door and I did, I let the light in, and I just kept saying to folk, see this Queen's Nurse thing, can we give it a try? And they kept in. And one of the first things that we did was create protective space in a busy working life where you don't think you've got time for anything. We created a protective space and we made it a minimum of 1 hour per week, which would be more deserved open time. And this would be free space within the team to reflect and share feelings, thoughts and experiences, and restart each of these sessions with mindfulness. And it's a 5 minute app on your phone, and we just switch it on, and we're all up here, and we switch it on and we just get ourselves down in the presence in that moment. And we also use something that we learned at Global Reaction Learning, still in the early stages, but we use that to address issues of discord and feelings and also the positive things that happen to us. And it's been absolutely fabulous. And I've been offered with a small change in the working week. Everyone looks forward to the whole time. Our students love it, and our staff are so connected with each other, and we're becoming more empowered and reflective. And I think that's a fantastic thing to happen. And one of the things, we recently had a management student, and she got community for a final grade placement. And so we were met with, she was raging that she'd been getting a grade placement, and we were met with real resistance. She did not want to be there. She wanted acute care, and she was difficult. But she came round because she felt nourished in our environment and said at the end of her placement how overwhelmed she was about her team's compassion and knowledge. And that was amazing. And one of the things we do during Golden Time is we have this session where we call Imagine If. And it's just asking that question, imagine if. Imagine if things would be done differently. Imagine if discharges were better. Imagine if we had more time for palliative care. So we had all these fantastic ideas that the team came up with. And we went to our senior management and we went to the acute care clinical nurse managers. And we do things differently now. We have set up a day in inreach in the hospital and we're facilitating fantastic discharges of palliative patients. We're getting patients home early and everything just is better. It's not perfect, but we're getting there. And we've also been developing partnership with home carers, providing informal teaching sessions to improve communication and patient care. And each stage of time I've been part of this and felt included and happy. That their ideas have been taken forward. I've shamelessly used my Queen's Nurse title as well to get involved in committees, just to promote what district nursing is, what we do, and how we can improve the care of patients at home. And I do this with my peer group as well, and we practice mindfulness, and we have adopted the ethos of compassionate leadership. We learn from each other, and we celebrate the power of connection, and we feel so happy to experience it. I've also forced, with the advanced practice element of the SPQ, I've forced a close relationship with the GPs and sadly I do advanced assessment of patients at home. And part of that is that I give and take and I need mentorship for my students, and so I do some work for the GPs and they do stuff for me. So basically, just to sort of pull it all together, because Penny's winking at me, I think the biggest impact of my learning experience and becoming a Queen's Nurse is sharing all that I've experienced and learned. I believe I've been a force for change, facilitate a more person-centred environment. I encourage everyone to be authentic, and I know we're busy, but business should not be how we're labelled. So, anyway, I'll just finish it up.